The Democratic race is not over until it's over, despite Hillary's claims. She won the California primary by a strong margin, partially because the Associated Press, based on the commitments of superdelegates, which can be changed in a minute, proclaimed her the winner of the nomination. So a lot of people who were opposed to her didn't vote, and a lot of the people who voted felt they needed to ratify her as the presumptive Democratic nominee, since the AP said she was going to win that anyway. The fact of the matter is that Hillary ends the primaries now with 198 votes short of the majority needed for the nomination in pledged delegates. In other words, in elected delegates who can't change their minds, who are bound to vote the way they're instructed, she falls 198 votes short of the majority required to win the nomination. Now, there are 720 superdelegates, and they can vote however they wish. 400 or 500 of them have stated an inclination to vote for Hillary, and it's based on that that AP puts her over the threshold. But that which they pledge can be unpledged. These are not legally bound delegates. And depending on the kind of month Hillary has, those pledges could be called into question. They certainly are not lead pipe cinches or locks. These are not Hillary fans who committed to Hillary. They're state committeemen, national committeemen, state party chairmen, congressmen, senators, and governors who are allowed to attend the convention and cast votes as they wish. And they're very susceptible, obviously, to political trends between now and then. So if the FBI investigation and or the Benghazi investigation lead into dangerous turf, you could see superdelegates refusing to vote for Hillary. And you could see enough doing so that she does not win a first ballot nomination, and that sentiment develops for Biden or for Kerry or for some other alternative. I outlined this scenario in Monday's video, and on Monday I raised the prospect that Hillary might lose California. Well, she won California and by a convincing margin. But while that makes this scenario slightly more remote, it does not eliminate it entirely. And if the month of June proves disastrous for Hillary, and there is a question of her being indicted, or the FBI makes a clear recommendation to that effect, even if the Justice Department does not act on it, there is more than enough wiggle room for Hillary to lose this nomination. So let's keep watching it. Thanks for watching.